This tiny teach is going to cover conjugation, one of the three methods of genetic recombination in bacteria. Conjugation is transfer of genetic material through direct cell-to-cell contact between bacteria. It requires two live bacteria, and it uses a conjugation or sex pilus. So we're going to start with conjugation between an F plus and an F minus bacteria. An F plus bacteria is called an F plus bacteria because it has the F or fertility plasmid. On that fertility plasmid is the gene to make a pilus and other genes as well. So an F plus cell has its main chromosome along with the F or fertility plasmid, and on that fertility plasmid is the gene to make a sex pilus and other genes, genes for things like antibiotic resistance or how to make a capsule. An F plus bacterium is going to be our donor bacterium, and it's going to conjugate with our F minus bacterium, which is going to be our recipient bacterium. This is called an F minus bacterium because it does not have the fertility plasmid. It just has its single circular chromosome. So in conjugation between an F plus and an F minus cell, my F plus donor bacterium attaches to my F minus recipient bacterium using a conjugation or sex pilus. The two bacteria are drawn closer together, and then one strand of the fertility plasmid is transferred from my F plus to my F minus bacterium using the sex pilus. Once the strand is transferred from F plus to F minus bacterium, both of them make the complementary strand. So at the end of conjugation between an F plus and an F minus bacteria, both of the bacteria are now F plus because they both now have the F or fertility plasmid. Now I'm going to continue with conjugation between an HFR and an F minus bacteria. Usually we see an F plus cell like this, where it has a single circular chromosome and the fertility plasmid, and they're separate from each other. But sometimes, for reasons we don't completely understand, the fertility plasmid integrates into the bacterial chromosome, causing what we call an HFR cell. An HFR cell still is F+. It has the fertility plasmid. It can make a sex pilus and do conjugation. It's just that the fertility plasmid is integrated right into its main chromosome. So an HFR cell is going to conjugate with an F- cell. Again, this is an F- cell because it just has a single circular chromosome, no fertility plasmid. This HFR cell is F+ because it does have the fertility plasmid DNA. It's just integrated into its chromosome. The HFR bacterium and the F minus bacterium are going to connect to each other using the conjugation or sex pilus and then draw closer together. And then the HFR cell is going to begin transferring DNA through the pilus to the F minus cell. But it's going to start at the middle of the DNA for the F or fertility plasmid. So you can see part of the F or fertility plasmid DNA is transferred over along with a bunch of chromosomal DNA. The two bacteria are never going to stay connected together long enough for the entire chromosome and the entire fertility plasmid to be transferred from HFR to F minus. That's never going to happen. They're going to break apart before that does. So my HFR cell would stay HFR, but my F minus cell would also stay F minus. It did get part of the F or fertility plasmid DNA, and it also got part of the main donor bacterium chromosome. And it will integrate that DNA into its main chromosome. So you can see part of the fertility plasmid DNA is there, part of the donor bacterium DNA is there, and then its F minus regular chromosomal DNA is there. So we still have a combination that's new that we didn't have before, but this F minus cell stayed F minus because it did not get the entire fertility plasmid.